Hi, this is the continuation of the last topic stack. In last video I have told if stack need to be created with these items, like 25 need to be inserted as first element, 32 is second, 50 is third, like 99 is the last element. If you want to create a stack with these elements, the 99 will be the final element, which is called the top of the stack. This is the final element. Similarly, the 25 is the first element, which doesn't have any element before it, or there is no previous element for the 25, so the address field of the 25 will be null always. So this is the main point we have to remember, where second element is pointing the address of the first element, third element is pointing the address of the second element, final element is pointing the address of the third element, and so on. So if you want to delete any element from this, you can only able to delete the final element, which is the top of the element. If you want to delete it by automatically, the element 99 will be deleted and the topmost element will become 50 at that time. So we will see one program, not a program, it is one of the game with the application of the stack called Tower of Hanoi. And to play this game, we need 3 pegs, or we need 3 towers A, B, C, where one tower is having number of disks in it. So there is a minimum number of moves to be needed to solve the game. Like if the disks are placed in the A peg, then all the disk has to be moved to the another peg, and we can use the third tower as the auxiliary peg. Okay, if you want to understand this problem, you need to know the concept of recursion. I'm not going to explain what is recursion. Those recursion topic I am not going to explain in elaborate. I am going to tell what is recursion, and I will show you one example so that you will understand what is recursion. First, you should know what is recursion. Recursion is the process in which a function calls itself, or a method calls itself. This is the meaning of the recursion. To know this, we have to see some examples. In recursion we have more number of examples. I am showing you here, it is a factorial. For example, I have taken 4 factorial. 4 factorial is equal to 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, where the value is 24. Here I have given 3 factorial. 3 factorial in the sense 3 into 2 into 1. So you can write the 4 factorial as 4 into 3 factorial. Again, this 3 factorial is going to repeat the same process, 3 into 2 into 1. Again, if you want to write the 3 factorial, you can write it as a 3 into 2 factorial, you can write it. Similarly, this process is going to repeat it again. In this case, if you will write some function which you want to repeat it again and again, you can write a function and you can call that function with it itself. So here that recursion will be used more. Understand? To understand this, I will show the program so that you will understand this more clear. To see with this same program with recursion, you should know the program of factorial first. I have already written the program for the factorial of a simple way and with recursion and without recursion. Okay, so first we will see the simple program for the factorial. Okay, so I have declared an header file, then this is a main program. In main program I have declared the variable. I will tell you why I need these 3 variables. Next, I have just given the printf statement, enter the number to find the factorial. So scanf is for getting that value from the user. Now I am writing the factorial with the for loop. I have created the for loop starting the I value is equal to 1 and I value is less than or equal to n. If in case if you are writing the n value is 5, then you have to get the value of factorial 5. So I have given I plus plus. Then I need one variable which I want to store the value of I into I. Means in case starting if I is equal to 1, then I need the first variable should be 1, so I have declared the variable f is equal to 1, and I is for the loop and n is for the value which has to be getted from the user. So I have declared 3 variable. If you are not declaring f is equal to 1, then this will be, you will be getting a wrong value. For that I am declaring f is equal to 1. So, and also I am saving that f value in f for the next multiplication. First case I is equal to 1, and already I have declared f is equal to 1, so 1 into 1 it will be stored 1. Then again it will go here, I is less than is equal to n, condition is 2, next increment, so f will become 2, 2 into 1, 2 will be saved here. Similarly next 3, then already 2 is there, so 2 into 3 it will be 6. Again next 4, so already here 6 is there, 4 into 6, 24. Again next case 5, then 5 into 24 you will be getting 120. In case of n is 5, then you will be getting the factorial value of 120. This is the just a simple program of the factorial I have given. The same same program I have written with the function. Okay, this value, not this value, this mathematical program of the factorial I have written it into the function. How you will write the function? Same method. Here I have just declared one function called fact of int. This is my function fact. Fact is a function of name of the function. Then inside this is the main program, similar same like this program. Here I have I will just leave the main function. Just I will tell you the function of the factorial, what I have written here. Just I have created f is equal to 1, initiated f is equal to 1, then inside that same f is equal to f star I, same operation I have written here. Okay, then this function I have called inside the main function. So for that I have created ff is the another variable. For that I have declared ff here. Next printf. In printf I have given the number and the see, in main function we are calling this user defined function. This function will be called here, so this will be executed and the value of this function will be written over here. So this is the same program, but we have written the factorial operation in the function. Okay, see, if you are not able to understand this same program with creating function, we cannot understand the factorial function, factorial program with recursion, we will not be able to understand. That's why I have just initially explaining what is a simple program of the factorial. Next I have written that same factorial function, factorial program with function. Next same factorial program with recursion we are seeing. So same program we are going to see. Instead this is with recursion. I have told you in the initial stage recursion is a process of the process of a function calling itself. So here also we have here initially we have declared a function called factorial. Here our function name is factorial. I have declared here, I have to define that function. Here I am defining the function factorial function. Just note it here, inside this function I am calling this function. So return of n star factorial of n minus 1. This factorial of n minus 1 belongs to the function name. So we are calling this function inside it, which means the function is calling itself. that is called a recursion. So this is the recursion meaning. So a function which calls itself is called a recursion. Here I have just given if condition n is equal to 0, then return value of 1, else return n star factorial of n minus 1. In case if your n value will be 5, then first it will check n is equal to 0. This is false, then it will execute the else condition. So n is 5, 5 into factorial of n minus 1. Here you will get it 4. Again this will go here, again it will check factorial of n minus 1. We are calling this function, again it will go here, this function. So again it will come, here the n value will be 4. This time also this condition is false. Again it will come, already 5 star, this function we have called, we have given return statement. So already 5 is returned, next factorial of 4 minus 1 is returned, so this will be 4. Again we have called, okay, so when this is 4 minus 1, it will be 3. Again it will be coming here, again this condition is false, again it will come here. Similarly, 5 into 4 into 3 into 1 instead 1, we have to return 1, so that you will be getting multiplication of 1 here. So this return value will be finally 120. We have called this factorial function here, so the value of 120 will be saved here, assigned to f. So we have just printed that value of n and f, so you will be getting the value of 120. So hope you understand what is the use of the recursion and how it has been used. These three are the same program for the factorial, but in simple way, and another one is with the function and another one is with the recursion. So I will run this program and I will show you how the output is coming. So I am just running the first program. Fact simple is the file name. Just I am executing this file. So you will see the output. It is asking for the number, I am giving 5. Next the output is 120. For this program we are getting the output is 120. Now I am running the program of factorial without recursion. So for this also we will be getting without recursion file. Again I am running, again you are getting 120 is the value. Next file is factorial with recursion is my file name. So here also we are getting the same value. So hope you understand what is recursion and everything. So this same recursion also we are going to use in the Tower of Hanoi also. If in case it is a means the number of disk is 4 in it, in that case the recursion will be used for moving the 4 disk to the another peg in this way. So here I am showing the video for Tower of Hanoi program. So there are 3 disk. Here the condition is always only one disk can be, means at a time only one disk can be moved to one tower to the another tower. Second condition is the bigger one should be at the bottom and the smaller one should be at the top. This is the condition. So the first condition is at a time only one disk can be transferred to another peg. Second condition is the smaller one should be placed on the taller, bigger one always. So with this condition we have to do the shuffling of position A to position C. You can use the another tower for the auxiliary peg. For changing your exchanging option we are using another peg. Like for to play this game we can use the stack, and also we have to use the recursion concept, because when this is transferred from this peg to this peg, there will be n minus 1 number of disk will come. Means two disk will be transferred to the second tower. Here the bottom one will be rest in A position. That time when you are getting n minus 1 disk, that time you have to move that bottom disk to the destination peg. This is the rule. At that time this two disk will be here. So this two disk, when this two disk will be here, this is the same condition. When this position A peg is having the number of disk here at the starting, means when it is having three disk, so similar to that, here also the disk will be two at the time, but the process is same again. Again you want to make this tower as getting n minus 1 disk here. So the process is going to repeat. If you are having 4 disk, that time 3 will be here and 1 will be at this place. Again this 3 will be, has to be changed, like same process. So here you have to use the recursion for the Tower of Hanoi program. So this is the algorithm for the Tower of Hanoi. For n number of disk, you have to write the algorithm. So the algorithm is like this: move the top n minus 1 disk to an intermediate peg. This is the first one. Second, move the bottom disk to the destination peg. This is the second step is this one. Third will be the, again you have to do the n minus 1 disk from the intermediate peg to the destination peg. This process has to be repeated. This is the algorithm for that. Just I have given the table. If you are having 1 disk, then how many moves? If you are having 4 disks, then how many moves? Like that I have given. So you can ask the application of the stack. So in real time, this is used to do the undo mechanism in text editor or Word or whatever the document it is. It will be used for backtracking. In backtracking, in the sense, in most of the games also we are doing the undo process, redo process, like that it will be used. Next will be the reverse word, the reversion of the word. You can do reverse with the stack. Expression evaluation is there. We will see about this in next upcoming topics. Infix, prefix, postfix expressions are there. In memory management also it will be used. Hope you understand what is stack and what is queue. In stack, and only one end is there where you can add the data and delete the data. In queue there are two ends, front end and rear end. If you have any doubts regarding stack or queue, you can do comment. And if you want any other topics from this topic, different from these topics, you can do mail or you can do comment. Thanks for watching. Hope you understand the concept of stack. We will meet in next video.